Okay, let's do some math for fun. Here, let's talk about two special functions that you probably have seen on WordFun Alpha, and we are going to make more sense of them in this video. Because keep in mind, the more functions that we have, the more integrals we can do, the more pleasures that we can have in our lives, isn't it? Yes. Therefore, let's take a look at these two integrals. Unfortunately, the answers to them are not elementary, but it's okay because we can use the special functions to help us out. Let's look at the first one, the integral of e to the x over x. Well, we can actually just answer this as ei of x, namely the exponential integral function, and the input right here is x. And after we put on the plus e, this is it. And now for the second one, the integral of 1 over ln of x. This right here, we'll just answer it as the, of course, I was going to put on the same integral. Just kidding. We're just going to answer this as li of x. And of course, put on plus e. This right here is the logarithmic integral function, and the input right here is x. And that's it. Right? Well, the deal is that if you differentiate this, you end up with e to the x over x. And if you differentiate that, you end up with 1 over ln x. Now, let's take a look at their definitions. Let's look at ei of x first. So let me put that down right here for you guys. In fact, this right here is defined in terms of integral. And if you look at Wikipedia, this right here is defined to be negative integral going from negative x to infinity. And here we have e to the negative t over t dt, like this. Again, if you differentiate this, you will end up with e to the x over x. And I'm really not sure why they defined it this way, because if you do a little substitution, if you let u equal to negative t, for example, so let me just put that down right here for you guys. You can take this into a better form, in my opinion. You end up with equivalent integral going from negative infinity to x. And you end up with the inside being e to the u over u du. And if you differentiate this, you'll still get e to the x over x. This right here, we're just using u as a dummy variable, and we're using t for the dummy variable right here. But don't let the t or the u bother you. That's the idea, right? And now you might be thinking, this is kind of cheating, because we couldn't integrate this, and we just, hey, say that's the answer for that, and just call that to be a new function. We just keep creating new functions for the integrals that we cannot do. Well, kind of, but in fact, a lot of functions are defined in terms of integrals. And the historical example is the log function. Log of x is defined to be the integral going from 1 to x of 1 over t dt. I have a video on that. You guys can go check that out. Right? So we just have to deal with it. Anyway, this right here, we have a small restriction. Right here, we cannot have the x to be 0. So I will just indicate that x cannot be 0 right here. I thought that's a little restriction. And other than that, that's all. Now, let's talk about li of x. And yes, this right here is also defined in terms of an integral. This is the integral going from 0 to x. And you can guess the inside here is 1 over ln t dt, like this. Well, the problem with this is that, of course, when we're dealing with log function, we cannot have negative input. Otherwise, we'll be in the complex world, right? So we first need to have x greater than 0. And if you have x is equal to 1, unfortunately, you won't get a convergent integral. You end up with negative infinity. I will leave that to you guys for you guys to try out. And here's the idea. We will just look at x not being equal to 1, like this. Yeah, if it's 0, it's negative infinities. Yeah, so that's it. Anyway, these two are the little restrictions for li of x. And in fact, I want to show you guys a really cool connection between e of x and li of x. But before I do that, let me tell you guys the big brother of li of x, namely the big li of x. Because as you can see, right here, if we go from 0 to x, that's no good sometimes. And yes, you might be thinking, hey, what if we have from 0 to 2? We will be crossing this 1, right? In that case, you will have to use what we call the Cauchy principle value to interpret that improper integral. But that will be for another video in the future. In this video, let's just talk about e of x and li of x, right? Anyway, the big brother, the big li of x, is defined to be let's just avoid that situation. So we start at 2, and then we go to x, like this. And we have 1 over ln t dt, like this as well. And a really cool connection between this and that is just that big Li of x is the same as Li of x. This is the little version, and then minus Li of 2. And of course, you can see pretty easily, because little Li of x goes from 0 to x, and this big Li of x goes from 2 to x. So that's pretty much the idea. You can just work out the little detail on your own. Now, let's talk about the connection between E of x and Li of x. Here is the one I wanted to show you. Let's observe. What if we have Ei of ln of x? Let's take a look right here to see what happened. In that case, let me just put natural log of x in here. Because again, this and that are equivalent. This right here, I think, is easier to work with. So let me just go from negative infinity to, for this right here, it will be just the ln of x. So I'll just put down ln of x right here. And we have e to the u over u du, like this. And now, we will just do a substitution. But I used the u already, so I will have to use something else. Let's use w. So I'm going to let w equal to e to the u and do our usual business. As you can see, dw is equal to e to the u du divide e to the u on both sides. So we get du equals dw over e to the u. And you can put the w right here if you would like, but it doesn't really matter. And let's see. Let's take this into the w world. For this integral, here we have u goes from negative infinity. And you put negative infinity to here, e to the negative infinity is 0. So that means w will start with 0. And then we put ln of x. Right here, e to the ln of x is just x, right? Because e and ln cancel, so w will be going to x, like this. And now, e to the u, let me just keep it as w, or let me just substitute to w, sure, why not? So this is w over u. Let's just take a natural log on both sides, so we get ln w equals u. So we have ln w right here. And then du is dw over e to the u is the same as w, so I can put the w right here. But the deal is this and that cancel each other out. As you can see, this right here is nicely equal to the integral going from 0 to x. And here we have 1 over ln w dw. And usually, as I like to tell you, I like to tell you guys that don't let u bother you. But in this video, I will tell you don't let w bother you. This right here is actually the same as that. Namely, we just get Li of x. So this is nicely equal to Li of x. So as you can see, we have Ei of ln of x. This is equal to Li of x. And then, you can probably guess it, if we have Li of e to the x, what do we get? Yes, this right here will get to Ei of x. Very, very cool. Alright, thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, that's it.